watch the first two series before the new one starts. As if tonight, 7:30, E4.
If you missed Channel 4's dark new drama, 6 Feet Under, E4 will be breathing life back into it tonight at 9 with another showing of the feature-length first part. But now, has Dermot come to praise Sandy or bury him? It's Little Brother.
O2 sponsors Big Brother.
Twelve hours ago, Sandy Cummings scaled that very wall. Do you want to know where he is now? Do you want to know what happened next? Well, you will, exclusively right here in the next half an hour. It's June the 12th. It's day 20. It's Big Brother's Little Brother. Yes, it's a beautiful panorama. And in many ways, tonight, we are panorama. We kickstart, as always, with Little Brother's big news. Thanks. Today's main story this morning at 7:30 a.m, Sandy scaled the walls of Big Brother, the Big Brother house, never to return. This footage was just taken moments after he touched the veritable Tina Nogue of outside the Big Brother house. We can see it there, I believe. There he is, leaving. Frenzy of people outside being escorted by guards. His producer Sally there talking him through life outside. Excitement, she wrote there. The Scot gave his first and only interview earlier this afternoon. This is just a snippet of what he had to say.
I think what people have got to remember is that they're called housemates, but actually they're not your mates.
I'll be enjoying my Martin Bashir moment in full with Sandy with the exclusive interview later on. And finally, after the repetitive rule breaking last night, Big Brother has had to severely reprimand the housemates for their behaviour. Kate and Spencer both received strikes for crossing the divide. Here is how Spencer reacted.
You get a strike? Yeah. Respect, man.
Did you get a strike?
Huh?
Did you get a strike? Well done, Spence.
She read all the things and said, you crossed the divide on 13 separate occasions. What?
13 times.
So I justified 5 of them with finding out the time, and the rest of them with waking people up.
All right, here to explain what happened this morning is the security guard who was on duty. Now, for security reasons, we can't give him his name. We can only call him B28. B28, good afternoon.
Hi.
How you doing?
Fine, yourself?
Excellent. Now, B28, when you first realised, when did you first realise there was someone trying to escape?
No, I was informed on the radio, and as soon as I left afterwards, I heard a noise coming from the garden inside the house, and the rest of the housemates was shouting, "Go, Sandy, go." And then when I turned around, I saw that Sandy was up there on the small roof.
Yeah, what, just up there on the grey bit?
Yeah, on the grey bit on the other side of the net, yeah.
Lovely. Was there any danger of him falling through that at all?
I don't know, it was quite fast. And after that, he just went up to the main roof, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
So then what happened? Where did he get?
He went up on the main roof and just passed those green nets, and then he slided down the scaffolding.
Yeah. He used to be in the army, you know.
Oh.
Yeah, so that's probably the reason why he can do it. Okay, so he got down this side. What did he then say?
No, absolutely said nothing. He just started running from over there, and he ran all the way up to the gate. The gate was closed, and we wouldn't let him out, so he wanted to climb up.
He wanted to climb up that?
Yeah.
Wow! And,
just as he was about to start climbing, we just, you know, just stopped him from climbing.
Yeah.
And just told him to calm down.
How did you stop him?
No, as soon as we grabbed him.
He grabbed him?
He just stopped, yeah.
Okay, cool.
And we just told him to relax. Mm-hmm. And he got down and we sat him down in our booth here.
Lovely.
And
then nice booth.
Then the senior producers arrived.
Did you have to call for reinforcements? Was it like a 9/11, or did you just do that on your own?
No, we called for reinforcements, and the other security guard from the NAS station came to assist me.
Okay.
And yeah, but he wasn't any trouble at all. So
brilliant. He was kind of amicable,
yeah.
Right?
He looked kind of well,
alcoholic. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. He looked a well alcoholic. Nice one. Thanks, B28. Certainly appreciate it. Thanks. Loving your work. We'll get the Purple Heart for this. Okay. Now, Alexander Cal Dumming, a.k.a. Sandy, was born on the morning of the 12th of January 1959 in Newborough, Fife. He entered the house on the 24th of May, 20 days later, and that's 1,124 early laps of the pool later, and 60 solitary hours in the garden. He jumped over that wall. So today on the show, we're asking him why. But first is Sandy, the story so far.
I'm Sandy, I'm 43 from Errolsfield, London.
Yo, guys! I'm the only Scot here, you know what I mean?
Stranded at the drive-in.
I actually don't mind being in here, yeah?
I've never shared a house in my life like students do.
Branded a fool.
They used that sugar for that cake, didn't they?
There isn't anything that I can say to you right now that would bother me and really want me to leave.
I'm completely mind-numbingly bored.
Bored at my skull.
Bored. No, I'm past bored.
What will they say?
I'll just tell you all up front, because it's easier. I'm leaving tomorrow.
You're joking.
You're joking.
Yeah. Son.
Sandy, I love to talk.
I'm in misery.
And also make people laugh.
That's it, I've got the house against me now.
I am sensitive.
I will cry tomorrow because I'm quite an emotional guy, although you wouldn't believe it.
We can also be tough.
We're sitting there like a bunch of morons. Because blubber guts wanted Chinese.
If you guys can't decide my fate, and the nation can't decide my fate, I'm going to decide my own fate.
Oh, Sandy.
Didn't see nothing there, did you? Here's the comment on today's shock event. Our two friends of the show, Dan Wakeford, been already Heat editor, news editor of Heat magazine, and Big Brother of Victor Ellison Hammond. Hey.
You're right, man. I'm blushing.
Are you?
I think I just saw something.
Did you see a bit of O'Leary action there?
I think I did, man.
Ireland's finest. Right, okay. Now, what either of you particularly... Well, you must have been shocked.
I wasn't shocked that he was coming out. I'd been moaning on about it for ages.
Yeah.
But it was quite shocking how he did it.
Yeah.
To see him up there with his army training, scaling the wall and on top of the roof was great. It was really exciting.
It is very much the JFK of Big Brother this year, as in, where were you when Sandy scaled the wall?
In bed.
Did you turn on TV and
I was
see
in bed
it,
just about to watch the football, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay, so...
But as soon as it happened, I had about three text messages telling me everyone was just, like, running around, texting everyone madly, because it was the most exciting thing that's happened. One of the most exciting things in Big Brother history, I think.
Nice touch. oh, here's coming back again. Alison, where were you?
I was in bed
at the
time. I wasn't that surprised. I actually saw everything, and he was eating his porridge every single day, wasn't he? And all that those laps in the pool, and I thought that was... preparation for it, actually. Oh, I think that was the preparation, all those laps and the porridge.
That was just so boring. He's been boring all the time he's been in the house, and now he's just done the most interesting thing he's done in 2 weeks. Is on the last day. He's just done it to be noticed, I think.
Do you think?
Yeah, it's just a big attention-grabbing scam, because it would have gone down in Big Brother history, as I was saying, it's been quite a boring housemate, but now he's...
He's been quite forthright, to be fair to him.
He hasn't interacted, he hasn't brought much to the agenda. He's taken himself away from everyone, which is... because he doesn't really get on with them. It's been quite boring for the viewer, and suddenly he leaves us in this big extravaganza of bitching, telling everyone exactly what he thinks, which is great.
Mm. You enjoyed it, though?
Yeah, really good.
OK, you spent 2 weeks with him. Did you see this coming? I mean, I know you say you thought he was training for it, but in all honesty,
I didn't know anything that... I just thought he was really dryness. He was, like, quite boring and everything. I never in the history of Big Brother thought he was going to do that. Definitely not. I thought he would just left by the back door. I mean, I said the other day, didn't I? If he wants to go. Just get out of there, man. But I never thought he'd climb up the trellis. He was doing his little Spider-Man thing, wasn't he? I thought he was going to bring out some silks for one minute.
When we spoke to him earlier on today, he did say, you know, there was no way he was leaving by the front door, no way he was leaving by the back. It was like, I've had plan A, I've had plan B, and it was plan C, and no one picked up on it.
No, oh. I did pick up on that plan.
Oh, you didn't say that yesterday.
I'm sorry, but I didn't think he was going to go for it. But I did overhear him saying something about a plan C, but that didn't kind of enter my head.
I think he's a control freak who's just trying to work his way against everyone else, and he just won't do things. He doesn't want to do things the way other people wanted to do them, and that's why he doesn't like being in the house. That's why he can't handle it.
Refreshing for Big Brother, though.
I do. I like the way that he's taken himself away from the people and finally told them exactly what he wants. but it doesn't really work as in great television because he's not interacting with everyone, and it just perhaps puts other people off as well.
Alison, did you have any hints whatsoever that this was going to happen? Did he hint to anyone in the house, do you think?
I think he's hinted to Alex, because that plan A, B, C, he was talking to Alex at the time when he spoke about that. But he never hinted to me at all about anything like that. But I think fair play to him, man. He went out in style. I like it.
OK, let's see live footage of the house now to see. We've been seeing a lot of footage today that is quite subdued. Sophie there, she's very upset. Eat something. Good to see that, you know, to comfort her. Lee, as you can see, very, very upset over there, cleaning dishes. Probably the first time Lee's ever.
He's probably asking a plate if it fancies him.
No, there he is, eating. Once again, trying to get something down him, just making sure. There we go. He looks beset.
They do look very depressed, don't they, Dermot?
Okay, in all honesty, though, they have been... we haven't got time for a producer chat today, but they have been, you know, they've been quite down about it today, by all accounts.
In what sense? They've just like been really not talking to each other?
I guess so, yeah. I mean, you know, they've just been...
I think it when somebody's taken away from them, someone who they've tried to bond with, and some the face they've been used to seeing, when they don't see that many faces at all on a daily basis, it does like hit them
like
really
hard. Like
a pack
of huskies, if one separates them. OK, now, Dan, Big Brother's supposed to be tougher this year. Do you think it's too tough?
I think possibly. It's great viewing, this Heaven and Hell format. It's fantastic, but I think there's a risk of other people leaving. I mean, I don't see Lee's already moaning about leaving. But
well, the weird thing is that both Sandy and Lee are on the rich side.
Exactly, but they're just not happy. They're not bonding. They're expecting it to be a fun, more communal experience, and they're not getting that. Mm-hmm. And I think they perhaps need to give them something more to do, because I know you're trying to test them and make it horrible, but I think they need mini tasks to do, something to boost their day, because they're just getting demoralised.
Lee's up for nomination this week. Do you think he'll go?
I think he'll go. It'd be quite close, because I don't think either of them are particularly popular with the public. But I think Lee's a little bit sleazy, asking everyone if they fancy him, trying to get it out of Adele and Sophie that they fancy him. And it's just, I think he's a bit duplicitous.
Nice touch. okay, bearing in mind you just talked about Lee, do you think anyone else just may give up and walk?
Do you think Jay, what do you think about Jay? Because I think Jay would be a little bit wobbly.
To tell the truth, I think she might talk about it, but in all honesty, I don't think Jay would ever walk. I think she's just too cool for that.
And also a quick chat with the others, and they would reassure her, and she'd be.
Yeah,
all right.
She would definitely stay there. She likes all the attention from everyone. Everyone sees her as a baby and the family. I think they'll look after her as well. Mm-hmm. Definitely. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I don't think she's going anywhere.
And do you think if Sandy's going to be replaced by another contestant, which
it should be me?
That can't happen. Would you go back in? Honestly.
Seriously, if you said, Alison, go back into that Big Brother house, I'd be there straight away.
I think it's a dangerous game putting anyone other than Alison back in, because same with Josh and Sophie, they don't live up to the promises. You didn't see Josh last year giving the things he promised, nocturnal activity, yeah. Naughtiness. He was just walked in there totally awestruck.
Josh and Pecks.
But all the hype wasn't there. The hype didn't. It didn't happen. And with Sophie, she's just like a wet weekend as well. You don't get the excitement.
Do you think
too late
she's
for them
cooking?
To bomb.
Yeah, she's a fantastic cook.
Hold Heat front page. Sorry, it's not interesting.
In all honesty, do you think it is? Do you think it's quite worrying if a new housemate goes in, because it's a relatively later stage?
It is really scary when you know you don't know what to expect or anything. And I think They're very bonded at the moment, and to bring someone else in, it's just so hard to integrate with that new person, and everyone wants to get to know them, and you're going to know in the back of your head they've been watching the programme as well. Mm-hmm. So you're thinking, oh, if they're not talking to me, am I coming across really badly, right, and things like that?
Yep.
So, yeah, it is quite important.
We've had loads of emails about the whole Sandy situation. We'll try and get them to you as soon as we can. Alison, this is your last day live with us, I believe. So
it's been
just
a pleasure, man.
Thank you very much.
Oh,
lovely flowers for you.
Can I just say, thanks to everyone who's behind the scenes who have been just so supportive. Yourself, I think you've been all wicked, man. I've really enjoyed myself.
No.
Thank you.
No, you can't. You can't say that, because simply they don't deserve it. Thank you very much, guys. Okay, after the break, our exclusive interview with Sandy, plus the latest news from the house. I believe we'll be seeing you in a minute.
E4's keeping Thursdays big.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Big Brother's Little Brother. Wow. We are bringing you the exclusive story of what's happening since Sandy escaped from the Big Brother house at 7:30 a.m. this morning. Now, after leaving the house, we invited Sandy onto the show tonight to tell his side of the story. He refused to return to the Big Brother premises, albeit probably understandably so. In an effort to find out exactly what happened, we tracked him down to a secret location, a hotel nearby. This is the exclusive interview that he gave me earlier on today. There are three of us in this marriage, Dermot. Wow, okay, I'm here in a secret location with Big Brother's first escapee, Sandy Cumming, and wife, Claire. You were scheduled to be leaving the house at 7 today. Why did you abandon idea and jump over the fence this morning, a la Papillon style?
I think if anyone knows me, they know that I can be slightly unpredictable. And I think that if I wasn't going to go out the front door, I didn't particularly want to go out the back door, so I decided the roof looked quite attractive this morning.
Everyone kept saying about you had a plan A, a plan B, but this plan is plan C.
Well, plan C was something that I had in my head from about day two or three. I kind of saw there was a loophole on the site, so I decided that when I got bored that it was time to go over the wall.
There are many people out there, understandably, who criticise you, 150,000 people, who replied, who think you've wasted a place. What would you say to them?
I would say apply next year.
Go on. In that what, you don't think you've...
I don't think I've wasted a place. No, I think that I went onto the show with no preconceptions. I did what I felt was right, and I left when I felt that I had to leave. So
do you think people can't understand the... I guess pressure's probably the right word, that until I go in there? Or were you under pressure? Do you feel it?
I actually don't think you're under pressure. I think that it's quite a tough one, actually. I think you've got to have some kind of stimulation. And I think it gets to the stage that if there's no stimulation, whether it be physical or mental, then I think something gives, and it gave. I mean, I just found that I wasn't getting anything from the experience, and I was quite honest, and I went and said, that's it, it's time to call it a day.
Looking back, do you wish you hadn't applied in the first place?
No, no. It's been an experience, and it's been interesting.
How do you think your housemates reacted to you going, or do you care?
If I'm being brutally honest, I probably don't care. I think what people have got to remember is that they're called housemates, but actually they're not your mates. They're people that are there for a reason, and it is, at the end of the day, it's a show, it's a game show or whatever. So I think that I'll be spoken about maybe today, and tomorrow I'll be forgotten about. There's been people evicted before me, and their names very rarely come up in conversation. So I think I'd be naive to think that, you know, suddenly, you know, Sandy is whatever.
But you don't particularly seem to care about that, though.
Oh, I don't, know.
That's probably one of the reasons why you left.
Yeah.
Is there anyone you're sad to leave behind? Anyone you expect to see again?
I think that, if I'm being honest, I think that probably Alex and Adele would probably be two people that I'd quite like to see again. I mean, I was very honest at the start of the experience. I sort of said, if I see any of them again, it'll be too soon. I think it's a very false environment. I think that anyone that thinks they can make great friends after 10 weeks of that kind of experience has been slightly naive. I think that it takes slightly longer than that, and it takes a slightly different situation.
Why do you think you and Alex connected? Just because you both seem to, you know, loathe the experience at the time?
Well, I think we both loathe the same things. Him and I just chatted. I mean, we've had problems, we chatted. I mean, we had some... I suppose out of all the conversations I had, his were probably the most stimulating. Him and Adele.
You seem to get with Spencer quite well, as well.
But Spencer and I just sort of dropped in and out of each other's conversation. We didn't actually like spend lots of time together, but we did. I mean, it was kind of funny, kind of like one word. It was like, all right. And it was just, you know, it wasn't like we sat for periods of time in conversation. We would just sort of sit down, chat, mimic each other, and then walk away again. So, you know. But no, it was, I mean, I can see a lot of Spencer. I can see me and Spencer when I was his age. That sounds really condescending, but he's a cool young guy. I mean, I think he's got his head screwed on. He knows where he's coming from.
But you probably wouldn't have tried it on with Kate 20 years ago.
No, she's blonde.
Fair enough. It became very apparent quite early on that you looked like you'd made a bit of a mistake going in there.
I would never say it was a mistake. I would say that it was an experience. I won't say it wasn't bad, it wasn't good, it was an experience. I think that maybe I was a bit naive. Maybe I thought that I was going to go in there and it was going to be something completely different. But I went in there, I enjoyed the experience as it was, and I knew when it was time. I think that fundamentally it takes quite a strong person to know when they've had enough and know when to walk away. And I knew it was time for me to walk away.
You didn't feel like you were quitting?
No.
Okay, so how are you feeling now? Are you relieved? Are you still maybe in a state of shock? Sad?
Well, I'm certainly not
happy.
Sad. I'm happy to see Claire. I just feel quite chilled. I feel that I've had an experience. I've had, you know, I'm glad that I went over the wall. I mean, that was exciting. I mean, that's the thing. There was nothing that exciting going on in there.
Not barbed wire around there.
No,
I'm very impressed.
Well, it didn't get me, so. The security guard was a bit stunned, but I mean...
I mean, what was, you know, your thoughts the minute you reached the outside world? You thought, okay, what do I do now? Do I run? Do I stay?
Well, it was quite funny because I kept thinking that I must find somebody and hand my mic to them because I thought that I'd be stealing a mic if I got away, you know, quite far. But obviously I didn't get that far because the security guard sort of got to me quite quickly. But I don't know, it was like a feeling of relief. You know, you sort of go, oh God, I mean, I can imagine what it's like escaping from somewhere now that you're not happy with.
That's because you had now first-hand experience.
Well, yeah. So it was probably the second, well, the most exciting thing that happened in the house for me was going over the fence.
Okay, what are your plans now?
I would like to probably go for a few drinks tonight, and I think I'm going away for the weekend, go to Europe.
And then straight back to work?
Probably back to work next week.
Okay, Sandy, thank you very much for coming on being so candid with us. Thank you very much, Claire.
You've
been a rock as always. All right then. For the viewers at home, here are a few of Sandy's most memorable moments in the house.
You know, the way I look at life is, if you've had enough of something, you don't do it anymore. If you're bored with something, you walk away from them.
Hi, how are you?
I think we'll make it onto Richard and Judy.
Cheers, Sam.
Cheers.
Cheers,
Sam.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Here we go. I've tried plan A, I've tried plan B. None of them have worked. So it's got to be plan C, isn't it?
Sandy, be careful! Sandy, be careful!
Sandy, be careful!
And as we wave goodbye to Sandy, we say thank you for your honesty. We salute you. Certainly was a very honest man. So that's pretty much all we've got time for today. Just to recap on breaking news, we received more news on today's reprimands. Every housemate was called individually into the diary room and reminded of the rules regarding the divide. They were told, and I quote, "Big Brother is requesting that you should go and read the rules carefully and think about whether you should be able to live within those rules." After discussing with the housemates the reasons for Sandy's departure, the housemates were told, "Big Brother would request that you go and have a think about whether you are up for the challenge or not." And finally, we can confirm the senior Big Brother producers are currently locked in talks about whether or not there will be a replacement housemate. As soon as there's any news, we'll let you know. You'll be first to hear on this show. That is pretty much it from us today. We're back at E4. 7 o'clock tomorrow night, and tune into Channel 4 tonight at 10 o'clock. Thanks for watching. See you then. Well, as